Hi! In this video, we will be looking at a stadium crowd created using CrowdSim 3D. CrowdSim 3D is a crowd simulation add-on for Blender. I use mocap data from Mocap Online. You can find the link in the description of this video. The data has been loaded into Blender and transferred to the armature of the characters we are going to use. The start and the end poses of each animation is in a key position. We have three key positions: standing, sitting with the hands on the knee, and sitting with the hands on the lap. We will select a follow-up animation based on the ending key position of the last animation. Here you see a transition animation. It is an animation that ends in another key position than it started in. We will later select follow-up animations based on the key positions the last animation ended. We are going to use a state machine for this. A state machine keeps track of the last key position of an agent. Based on the state, the agent can select a random follow-up action. I first created a spreadsheet containing all the actions with its starting key position and the key position on the last frame. All the preparations have been done. Now we need to fill the stadium with agents. For each section of the stadium, I created a collection containing the agents. This allows me to duplicate the collection and use the same pattern for a new section. Using collections is a time saver, as you can disable the selectability of sections you don't want to interact with. I enable snapping to make sure that the agents are positioned correctly. Let's look at the behavior. In the side panel of the CrowdSim node editor, I added a state property. This property will be used to record the key position of each agent. The type of the property is a string, and its default is the starting key position that each agent is in. In the behavior tree, we check the key position of the agent. Using a conditional node and a check state node, we check the state of the agent. On the first frame, the state is initialized with the default, sitlap, what will evaluate the part of the behavior tree for the sitlap state. A selector node is used to select a random child branch. These branches connect to a play action node to play an animation. When the animation ends in a new key position, we update the state property. For sit knee and standing, a similar structure is created. Using the debugger, we can follow the decision an agent makes and its flow. After executing the behavior, the first frame aren't that interesting. All agents start in the same position, and it takes some time to randomize the animation. After several seconds, a crowd animation emerges. In this video, we have shown how you can create a cheering stadium crowd using CrowdSim 3D. We showed how to duplicate sections of the stadium to quickly fill the stadium. We showed how to use the state property to keep track of animations. Thank you for watching.